Greetings, Eric Bakker. Thank you for coming back. Interesting study I was just reading online, and I thought I'd create this video in response to some questions I've had about the importance of sleep and getting your gut right when it comes to sibo or candida or parasites. A study conducted in Sweden in 2016 by this guy, I think he's doing a bachelor or master's program. So he put a whole bunch of about 20 guys through this test basically to see what would happen with their gut. And what he discovered, interestingly, was with 2 days of partial sleep. So when these guys were sleeping for, you know, 3-4.5 hours for over, you know, 2 days, so, you know, 3.5 hours on one day, 3.5 or 4 hours on another day, when they got partial sleep cycles, it significantly impacted on their gut microbiota. In fact, there were huge, big changes in the ratios of some of the beneficials. So we've got major groups of bacteria in the gut. You know, firmicutes, bacteroides, prevotella, a bacteria like this are important ones. And particularly the bacteroides and firmicutes ratios are completely altered through the partial sleep. Now, these guys weren't taking antibiotics. They weren't, you know, drinking Dr. Pepper and having pizzas all the time. These were just people in a lab doing a controlled study with their gut checkup before, during, and after, you know, this sleep test. And this researcher was stunned to see such an incredible change in the gut microbiota because of poor sleep cycles. So this is dramatic information for people, you know, their shift workers or airline pilots or people that work crazy hours or sleep-deprived people. I've always hammered on about the importance of sleep when it comes to restoring your health, and particularly when it comes to restoring your gut. I've known this for decades, that people with poor sleep always have poor digestive health, especially when they get really, really disrupted sleep cycles. So it's important for you to understand that. The other interesting thing the study found was the insulin sensitivity, okay, increased by 20%. So people who've got, again, poor sleep cycles tend to have more of an insulin, you know, level like that of obese people do. So having broken sleep can push you also more into craving sugar, wanting more carbs, getting, you know, bigger and fatter, all because of poor sleep. So it's very important that the sleep is fixed up. Check out some of my sleep videos. I'm sure I would have spoken about sleep on this channel. Otherwise, you can go to ericbakker.com and have a look at my page on sleep. It's one of the most important things you want to cultivate for good health, is a good sleep cycle. Thanks for tuning in.